function in array, and why we are using for each function in array. Anyone, any idea?
No, ma'am.
Others, any idea? Okay. So basically, the for each function is used for fetch the data from array. So I explain you with example. So it's print C, C++, Java. So it's fetch the data. So basically in this code, we are write variable array is equals to C, C++, Java. Then we are write array dot for each function fetch, because we can fetch this data. So that is why we write fetch, and then we print the fetch in as an output. So it's fetch the data like C, C++, Java. So, have you any doubt in for each function in array? Hello, any doubt? Hello? Say yes, no, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Others, okay. So next is include. So have you any idea what is includes function in array? Any idea? Okay. So basically, it's check the array, its content contain the specific element or not. So I explain you with example. So it's written true. So they like include function basically checks that check that the array like AngularJS, Node.js, and jQuery, it's present the data, like we are fetch particular data with, that are present in this form in this array or not. If it is present, then it's return the true, and if it is not present, so it is it's return the result as false. So basically, like in this code, we are write variable array AngularJS, Node.js, and jQuery. Variable result is equals to array dot includes jQuery. So jQuery is present in this array. So that is why it's return the output as true. If it is not present in this array, so it's return the false. So basically, this is include array include function. So have you any doubt in array include function? Hello, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So next is reverse function. Have you any idea of what is reverse function? So basically, yes, sir, please. Hello? Okay, so reverse function basically reverse the given array. So I explain you with example. Excuse me, who is Ashish Kumar? Hello? So basically, it's return the string and return the array in reverse order. So basically, in this code, we have declared the variable array is equals to AngularJS, Node.js, and jQuery. Then we are create another variable, which is variable reverse is equal to array dot reverse function, and then we print the this reverse in this and that the reverse the array. Like first it prints jQuery, then Node.js, and then Angular.js. So have you any doubt in reverse function in array? Hello, any doubt? Okay, so next is sort function. So have you any idea what is sort function in array? Any idea, anyone?
Arranging data in
Okay, so basically it's return the element in a sorted order. So I explain you with example. So basically, sort the array in alphabetical order, or you can say the alphabetical order or ascending order. So basically, like in this code, we are write variable array is equals to Angular.js, Node.js, jQuery, Bootstrap, and then we are write variable result is equals to array dot sort and document dot write line result. So basically, the A is first alphabet, then B, and then similarly arrange this array in a alphabetical order, or you can say the sort the particular array. So that is why it show the output Angular.js, Bootstrap, jQuery, and Node.js. So have you any doubt in array sort function? Hello, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Next is unshift function. So any idea what is unshift function in array? Okay, so basically, the unshift function is add the element at the beginning of given array. So I explain you with example. So it's at the jQuery at the first element. So basically, the unshift function at the particular element which is given in unshift as an argument. So it's at this first jQuery as a first element in array. So basically, like in this code, we are like variable array is equals to node.js, angular.js, and then we are right. Variable result is equals to array dot unshift jQuery, and then we print the result. So we write array, so jQuery present as a first element. So this is the output of this code. So any doubt, anyone? Unshift function. Any doubt?
No ma'am.
No ma'am.
Okay. Others, any doubt? Okay. So next is last index of. So have you any idea what is last index of function? Any idea, anyone? Okay, so basically it searched the element at the index last position. So I explain you with example. switch return 3. So basically, like in this code, we are write variable array C, C++, Python, C++, and Java. Then last index of C++, so it's written 3, because like in this for in this array element, C++ is 1, is 2, and then last index of is like we are right, C++ is 3 times, like third time, so that is why it's print output as 3. So have you any doubt in last index of function? Hello. Others, any doubt? Okay. So next topic is JavaScript functions. So have you any idea what is functions? In simple programming languages like C, C++, Java, what is function in simple words? Okay. So basically the functions is used to perform certain type of operations. Basically the function is basically two types, with argument and without argument. With argument and without argument. So first one is function with no argument. Have you any idea what is function with no argument? Anyone, any idea?
Does not pass the value.
Something else? Others? So exactly, like function is with no argument, which means we are not pass any type of argument in function. So I explain you with example. It's print hello, welcome. So basically, like in this code, we are create the function msg, which is message, and write the alert hello, welcome, and then close the script tag, and we are create a button. When user click the button, so the message function is called, and the output present as hello, welcome. So this is basically the call the msg, which means message function. So when user click this click this button, so it's show the hello welcome, which is present in this alert message. So this is basically function with no argument. So have you any doubt in this? Any doubt, anyone?
No, ma'am.
Others, any doubt? Okay. So next is JavaScript function with argument. So like with no argument, which means we are not pass any argument. And with when we write with argument, which means we pass some argument in function. So I explain you with example the function with argument. It's written give the 64. So basically we are passed the argument in getCube function, which is number, and we write alert because we find the cube of any number. So we write number into number into number, and if we find the square, so we write number into number only. So then we create the form, input type is equals to button, value is equals to click, and on click getCube the value is, we are passing is 4. So it's return the cube of 4 number, which is 64. When we click this click, and the output is 64. So this is basically a function with argument. So have you any doubt in function with argument? Hello, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Others, any doubt? Function with argument.
No, ma'am.
So third one is function with return value. So have you any idea what is function with return value? Any idea? Okay. So basically the function returns some value. So I explain you with example. So it's written hello welcome. So like in this code we I create function get info and this function return hello welcome, and then we close the script tag. Again we are start the script tag and the call this function in our document.write line get info. So basically it's written the value hello welcome as output, like hello welcome. So basically the return function return the return function value. So basically in this code the value is hello welcome, that is why it's written hello welcome. And if we are for some real-time project, so maybe it's written if we are working on a numerical value, so it's written any numerical value as well. So have you any doubt in a function return function function return? Any doubt?
Ma'am, can you explain it one more?
Yeah, sure. So basically we are create the function get info. Okay, so basically this function return like this is this basically return the string value. If you're working on any numerical, you write any numerical value, so it's also written any numerical value as well. So in this case it's written hello welcome, and then we are close the script tag, and again we are call this get info. So basically this get info return the hello welcome. So when we call that get info function, so it returns hello welcome as output on the screen. So I think you understand, or any problem? Okay. Others, any problem or any doubt in return function? Hello, any doubt?
No.
No, ma'am.
So next is JavaScript function methods. So the different type of function methods. First one is apply, bind, call, and toString. So I explain you one by one. First one is apply function. So basically the apply function contain the value and single array argument. So I explain you with example. So, like it's apply the maximum value. So basically, in this code, we are write variable array is equal to 7591, and then variable maximum. So maximum dot apply. So basically, it's apply the find the maximum value. So that is why we write maximum dot apply null and array, which is array. Basically this array 7591, and then we write document.write maximum. So the apply function to find the maximum value in a given array element. So basically the maximum value is 9, so that is why it present a 9 as output. So this is apply function. So have you any doubt in apply function? Hello, any doubt, anyone? Hello, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So next is bind function. So have you any idea what is bind function? Okay. So basically the bind function is used to create a new function. So I explain you with example. It's present demo. So basically, in this code we are create variable website, and website name is demo. Get name function we are called function. This function return basically name of the website. Okay, then we are close this, and then we are write variable unbound get name. So basically, this is the function name unbound get name. So basically, it present the website. Get the website name. So we are write website.get name, and then we are again write variable bound get name, which is equals to unbound get name dot bind, which is website. Basically, it's bind the website. So when we call this bind get name function, so basically it's called the website name, which is demo. So that is why it show the output as dot demo. Any doubt in bind function? Basically, the unbound get name or get, this is the function. Any doubt, anyone, in bind function? Hello.
Ma'am, extend once again.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, this is the variable. The variable name is website, and the website name is demo, and then we write get name function. So basically, this is the function, and this function return the name of the website. Okay, then we write variable unbound get name. So that's get name, basically get the name of the website, which is demo. Then we write get name. So when we write get name, so it's fetch the name, which is demo. And then we write variable bound.getName is equals to unbound getName. Basically, this is the function of use for the binding. So we are write unbound.getName, then bind this website. So basically, this when we bind this website, so it result as an output is demo. So then we are write the bound getName. So basically, the getName return the demo, the website name. Basically. So any doubt? Others have any doubt? Hello?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So the other topic we are discussing tomorrow class. Shruti ma'am? Ma'am, you can take the attendance.